Okay, on this video, we're going to talk about something that's called the Switchboard Manager. The Switchboard Manager allows you to make a really nice menu, either for yourself or for the end user. And it's actually pretty easy to do. So what we're going to do is we're going to pick on Database Tools. And then you come over here, you pick on the Switchboard Manager. In the previous versions of Access, by the way, it wouldn't say Database Tools, it would just say Tools. And then under that, there would be the Switchboard Manager. So we're going to pick on that. Now the first time that you run this, it's going to say the Switchboard Manager was unable to find a valid switchboard in this database. Would you like to create one? Yes, we would. So we'll pick on Yes. Now, imagine the switchboard is just a menu of choices. So it already makes the main switchboard for you, which is the main menu. So you're going to pick on the main switchboard, and then over here you're going to pick on Edit. Now, you're going to build each choice individually. So we'll pick on New here. Okay, let's say the text is going to be Add a New Order. You can put anything into the text, obviously. Now the command, we're going to click on that pull down, and these are the different things that the switchboard can do. Where it says go to switchboard, we can actually have a sub switchboard. Open form in add mode means that it's going to open up that form and automatically add a new record. Open a form in edit mode means it's going to go to the form and pull up your existing records, and it's going to bring you to record number one, but then you can change your existing records. Open report means it's going to run a report. Design application is going to put you into design view. Usually you wouldn't allow the end user to do that. Exit application will take you out of access. We can also run macros and run codes from the switchboard. So let's go ahead. We're going to say open form in add mode. What that means is it's going to open up the order form and add a new record. So then for the form, we're going to make that into the orders form. All right, so the text is add a new order. The command says open form in add mode, and the form says orders. We're going to click on OK, and that'll be the first choice in our menu. Let's have another choice, so we'll pick on new again. Now I'm going to say look up existing orders for the text. The command is going to be open form in edit mode. This time I wanted to go to the existing orders, and the form is still going to be orders. All right, so this time it says look up existing orders for the text. The command says open form in edit mode, and the form says orders. Let's click on OK there. Now let's say I want to be able to run that report right from the menu. So I'll pick on new, and I'm going to say run orders report. This time the command is going to say open report. And then notice how the bottom one changes to report. We'll click on that pull down and it'll show you the list of the reports. We'll use the orders report. The text says run orders report. The command says open report, and the report name is orders. We'll click on OK. And now let's say we want to print our labels from the main menu as well. So we'll have another new choice. We'll pick on new. This time I'm going to say run labels for the text. The command is going to be open report. And then the report name will be the labels, you know, that we made previously. So we'll click on OK. And now you can see we have our four choices on the menu. You could have as many as you wanted to. Actually, I think each switchboard can have 8 different choices. If you need it more than 8, then you will start to add additional switchboards. I'm going to click on Close here. And if you needed to add additional switchboards, you can do that over here. But right now, I just need the main switchboard. We're going to click on Close. Now, the switchboard is actually another form. So I'm going to come down here, and notice how in forms, I have a new form that's called Switchboard. That really was not there before. So I'm going to double-click on that. Notice it made a really nice menu in less than a few minutes. So let's try these out. If I pick on Add a New Order, notice how it opened up that order screen that we made in a different video, and it adds a new record automatically. So let's put a new record in here, and we'll put an order in. Let's say we're going to pick on the calendar, and we'll pick on today's date and the required date. Maybe it hasn't shipped yet, so we'll leave that blank, and maybe for the amount we'll say that was $300. So just like that, we added a new order. I'm going to close that window. And look, it goes right back to the main menu. Now, the reason it did that is because we said open form in admin for the switchboard manager. I'm going to say lookup existing orders. Now, notice how it opens up the orders form. It brings you to the first record, right? Then we can go through the records, or we can search the records to find a specific one. So we're going to close that. Now, over here, it says run the orders report. Oh, by the way, the second choice did that because we said open form in edit mode. We're going to say run orders report. Now, here's the report that we made in a previous video. All right, so that's right part of the main menu now. And now when I close the report, it goes right back to the main menu. Now we're going to run our labels. By the way, these two choices are working because we said open report. Now we're going to run the labels. Every time we run the labels, well, here's the labels, and then we would just print those as such. We're going to close that window. And just like that, we have a beautiful main menu for our users. We did that with the switchboard manager. If you ever want to change the switchboard manager, you can do that. You would pick on database tools, you pick on switchboard manager. Now you see the main menu is there. To change the main menu, we would just pick on edit, and now we can add or change choices or even delete choices if we needed to. But it's just a very, very powerful tool. It's called the switchboard manager.